Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to see how to build an advanced data logger that can run on simple AA batteries for about 2 weeks using Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. 6 months ago, I built my first data logger using an Arduino Nano and the DS3231 real-time clock. I wanted to build an advanced version of it for a long time, and when I posted that idea on the website, along with many other project ideas, most of the visitors voted to build this project first, so here it is. The advanced Arduino data logger is capable of logging temperature, humidity, barometric pressure and light intensity for about 2 weeks using simple AA batteries. It stores the data on a micro SD card in a .csv file format in order to be able to import this file to any data processing software afterwards. It is not an easy project to build for a beginner to Arduino, so if you are new to Arduino, please watch and build the project I will post in the cards here first. These videos will provide you all the know-how required to build this project successfully. The parts needed in order to build the project are these: an ATMEGA328 chip with Arduino Uno bootloader, a 16 MHz crystal, a DS3231 real-time clock module, a BMP180 barometric pressure sensor, a BH1750 light intensity sensor, a DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor, an SD card module, a big breadboard, and finally some wires and batteries. In order to program the 80 mega chip, we're going to need a programmer like this one. Or if you don't have one, all we need is an Arduino Uno board like this one. The cost of the project is less than $20 and we are using some of the most accurate sensors available, so the readings we are going to get will be very accurate. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. Now let's put all the parts together. First, we place the 80MEGA328 chip on the breadboard. We connect the 16 MHz crystal to pins X1 and X2. Please watch the detailed tutorial I have prepared on how to build a bare Arduino board. You may also need to connect two 22 picofarad capacitors, but in my case it is not needed due to breadboard's capacitance. Then we place all the parts on the breadboard. The top rail of the breadboard is going to be the power rail. So, at first I connect all the power pins from all modules except for the SD card module to the breadboard positive rail. We are going to provide power to the module from a digital pin of Arduino in order to be able to turn them on or off at will. The problem is that each digital pin of Arduino can provide up to 40 milliamps of current and the SD card module requires up to 200 milliamps. That's why the SD card module is going to be powered from the batteries directly, but we will get to that later. Next, we connect all the grounds to the breadboard ground rail. The DS3231, the BMP180 and the BH1750 modules use the I2C protocol in order to communicate with Arduino. For that reason, I will make the bottom power rail of the breadboard to be the I2C bus. From this bus, all the I2C modules we use will communicate with Arduino. So, from each I2C module, I connect the SDA pin to the top row of the power rail and the SCL pin of each module to the bottom row. Now, all we have to do is to actually make it an I2C bus by connecting it to the 80 mega I2C pins. The top row SDA goes to analog pin 4 and the SCL row goes to analog pin 5 on the 80 mega chip. That's it, most of the modules are now connected. Next, we connect the DHT22 sensor. We only need to connect the middle pin to digital pin 2 of the 80 mega chip. Next, we connect digital pin 3 of the 80 mega chip to the breadboard's top positive rail. The last module we have to connect is the SD card module. We connect the VCC of the module to VCC pin of the 80 mega chip, which is going to be connected to the batteries. Next, we connect the remaining pins of the SD card module. MISO pin goes to digital pin 12 on the 80 mega chip. MOSI pin goes to digital pin 11 of the 80 mega chip. SCK pin goes to digital pin 13. Lastly, pin CS goes to digital pin 10. That's it. It was not that difficult after all. Now all we have to do is to connect power from the batteries to VCC and ground pins of the 80 mega chip. If you wish, you can connect an LED to digital pin 7. If everything works okay and the SD card module is ready to record data, the LED will turn off after a few seconds. Okay, it works fine. You can find the schematic diagram of the project in the project page on my website educates.tv. Check the description of the video for the link.
Now, let's see the software side of the project. In this project, we use a few libraries, one for each module. You can find links for all the libraries I use in the description of the video. At first, there are a few things we have to configure. We have to define the altitude at which the project will run in order to have accurate barometric pressure measurements. Next, we have to define if we want the temperature to be measured in degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit. The next step is to set the interval for the measurements in minutes. Lastly, we have to set the time if it is not already set at the real-time clock module. In order to set the time, we enter the current time here and uncomment this line of code here. We upload the program once and the time is set. Next, we have to comment this line of code again and upload the program once more to Arduino. The code is simple. In every loop of the program, we first provide power to all the modules by writing hi to digital pin 3. Next, we enable the other digital pins and we initialize the SD card module and all the sensor. This may take some time, so we wait for a few seconds. Next, we read the values from all the sensors and we write all the values in the SD card. Next, we disable the power for every module by writing low to digital pin 3 and we go to sleep using the low power library. After we wake up, the loop starts over again. Next, we upload the code to Arduino. I am using an old Arduino board in order to make things easier. I program the Arduino Uno and then I remove the 80 mega chip and place it on the breadboard. Let's now measure the power consumption using a multimeter. As you can see, when Arduino powers up, it draws around 21 milliamps for around 15 seconds. Next, the circuit goes to sleep. Everything is disabled except for the 80 mega chip and the SD card module, so we now need only 3.5 milliamps of current. When Arduino wakes up, it works for 15 seconds and goes back to sleep. I tried to disable the SD card module as well using a transistor when Arduino was sleeping. The power consumption in this case dropped at 0.06 milliamps, which theoretically could make the batteries last for over 2 years. Unfortunately, when I tested the project in the SD card, some entries were missing and at random times Arduino was rebooting. So I decided not to disable SD card in order to have a stable project, but of course a big power consumption. Now let's put the project into action. I am going to let it measure the environment for a day and afterwards I am going to plot the results in Excel. I have set the interval to 1 minute, so we are going to get one entry of data every minute. One day later, in the SD card, the file log.txt contains all the data that the Datalogger gathered. There are almost 1200 entries. Each line contains an ID, the date and time, the temperature, the humidity, the barometric pressure, and lastly the light intensity in lux. Each value is separated by a comma, so it is very easy to process in any data processing software. We can easily import them in Excel and plot the data. All we have to do is to select the data tab, click on From File icon and select the log file that we have created. Next, we say to Excel that it is a comma delimited file and we press Finish. Now that the data is in Excel, it is very easy to process them and plot them. For example, if I select the date and temperature row, I press the Insert tab and I can select any chart. It is that easy. So that's the advanced Datalogger project. I thought it would be easier to work with the SD card module, but it is an unpredictable module. So if you only need to store a few kilobytes of data, better use the EEPROM memory of your Arduino board. I am going to work more on this project to see if I can make it to last more on batteries. Do you have any tricks to share with us about the SD card usage? Have you built any projects with an SD card module and want to share your experiences? Please post your comments below. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.